We're here in the Houston Astrodome. It's where it all happens. We talked with her earlier. We'll show you that in a minute. But right now, live from the stage of the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo, it's Reba McEntire.
And here we are with the one and only Reba McEntire. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
I'm good. Thank you for taking the time.
My pleasure.
Now, you're not any kind of stranger to rodeo.
No, I'm a third-generation rodeo brat.
Yeah. Now, we were talking before we came on here. Is it odd for you to be here, though? Because it's like a different group of people entirely.
Yeah, it's like you walking away from the music business for about 20 years and going back and everybody's different. There are a few of the people that were rodeoing when I was rodeoing that are still around, rodeoing, but a lot of newcomers, just like in the music business. Yeah.
Do you still get the urge every now and then to compete?
Let me think
on
about
any
that.
Level?
No.
No. Okay, you're past it. Good, good. I rode one of the Longhorn steers in the grand entry tonight.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that's as close to the competing as I'm going to get.
I wished I'd have known that.
I looked like such an idiot.
Oh, I bet you looked
Which
great.
Is, no, that's the desired effect. That's what we try to do on a regular basis. And we accomplished it today.
Oh, that's fun. That's fun.
Now, you recently got a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
Yeah.
Now, I know one of your neighbors is Meryl Streep. Mm-hmm. Do you know who's on the other side? Do you have
any
idea?
When it's Meryl Streep, you don't have any idea. You don't even care
if
it's Meryl Streep right there.
You just sit there and just go.
Meryl Streep.
Do you have any desire to police your area?
No, I think they'll take good care of me.
Will they?
Yeah.
See, I think if I ever got one, I'd want to just go back and sweep every now and then.
Would you?
Yeah.
Polish?
Yeah, make sure there's no gum stuck to it.
I am going to go back and look at it, though, because everybody was there and they had, carpet out and I couldn't see everybody else's names.
That's awfully cool, though.
It is.
Did you ever dream Oklahoma girl winding up with a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame?
Oh, sure. Yeah, because when the first time I ever went out to L.A., we were right in front of the Chinese Theater, and I saw the stars in the sidewalk, and I said, who gets this? And they well, entertainers do. And I said, wow, man, I want to do that one of these days.
No kidding?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, that makes it very special.
Yeah, but I thought just movie stars did, so I wanted to do that, too.
Well, now, speaking of movie stars, you're acting as it's taken up more and more of your creative energies, I would think, because I see you appearing in things a lot more. One thing, though, that I know you didn't appear in, and this has got to kill you a little bit, because I know you well enough to know that you are driven to squeeze life for every single drop it's got in it, and a missed opportunity is not your favorite thing to have happen. The Titanic story.
It really didn't bother me one bit.
Oh, don't give me that.
Honest engine. When I went and watched it, I thought, man, Kathy Bates did a wonderful
job. She did an amazing
job. It was her
job.
Part. That was for her. When it came down, I was going to have to eliminate 6 months of touring.
Oh, that's not good.
They wanted me for 3 months, and I said, okay. Then we moved our show dates to this other 3 months. And they said, no, not that 3 months, this 3 months. Well, you can't go back and take those 3 months back.
No.
Because the venues were already taken.
Yeah.
Whether by another country artist or rock and roll artist or the circus or ice hockey. And so we would have been out 6 months of working time. And they weren't paying me enough on the Titanic
That's
to make the payroll.
The unsinkable Molly Brown said,
would have been sunk.
I'm sinking
so
now.
So we had to stay with our show dates and fulfill the commitment that I said first I would do.
Yeah, okay.
So that's what Mom and Daddy taught me to do, and I did it.
That's the way it ought to be. Let's go back in time just a little bit to Forever Love, which, you know, I have a little access to some of them television numbers.
Yeah.
You knocked it so far out of the park. You won your time slot, and it was great. Are you planning to do more and more of that stuff?
Yes, I really do enjoy it. I've been reading scripts ever since the movie started production.
Right.
A year ago. And so we've been very busy. We've got several things that are in production again. We are creating two movies right now, and we're waiting on two scripts to be written, finished, and back to us. So we're very busy. We're very creative in the creative process of it. Good. And hopefully we'll be filming this May or June.
Now, in Forever Love, you were in a coma for, what, the first 25 minutes, I guess, of the thing. How difficult is that? Or did you just get a nap?
Oh, that was the easiest part of the whole movie. The only thing, you know, it really gets really bad when you're laying in bed and it's 11:30 in the morning.
Yeah.
And you've, you know, been on the set since 5 or 6 o'clock. And it's 11:30 and they say, okay, action. And then Tim Matheson walks up to my bed, who played my husband. And about that time when he starts to say something, my stomach goes. cut, Reba. Good lands. I said, what if you'd feed me?
So you got to remember to have breakfast.
Have something to eat, yeah.
It's hotter than 6 in the bed in here. Could somebody throw me this? Is it just burning up in here to you? Okay, it must be me just being very. Now you cry a lot in this movie. Do you have a place that you go in your head to motivate that, or do you just scream?
Yeah,
I
pick different things, emotional times in my life.
Yeah.
I hate to say it helps, but it doesn't take long for the tears to come when you think about very sad things in your life.
Yeah, it's interesting. That's just a tiny example of how the most horrible things that you could ever dream of that happened to you actually do have real value.
Well, yes, they do. They hit hard, and the memories hit hard. You never forget them.
Yeah.
And they're right there all the time.
Yeah, they are. Now, you also do quite a few love scenes or some steamy moments.
One.
Well.
Okay, two.
Yeah, okay. Is that a difficult thing to do?
With Tim Matheson, no. Tim put me at ease the very first day, just like Bess Armstrong, who was also in the movie. Bess and I, it felt like I'd known Bess all my life.
Wow.
And with Tim, we were instant friends. His wife and children came on the set, and we were very comfortable with being actors.
Good.
But acting comfortably with each other.
Good.
It was so much fun to get to work with him. He is wonderful.
I started to say never had to do that. I should rephrase, never got to do that.
Yeah.
And I've always been curious. We got to take a quick break, but we'll be right back, folks.
Hey,
Welcome back. We are talking with Reba here, and I know you're one of the best about staying really connected with the fans. You understand the value of really, you know, being accessible.
I appreciate them 100%.
We posted an opportunity on the internet for our folks to email you questions. Uh-huh. And we pretty much shut down country.com for a little bit.
Whoa.
We got a bunch. And,
okay.
And if you wouldn't mind.
Not at all.
Okay.
Not at all.
Okay. This is from Diane Huber. And the question is, do you find it hard to be a celebrity mom when you try to attend Shelby's school activities or sporting events? Do people try to get your autograph or do they just let you be Shelby's mom? Is that difficult for you?
Hadn't been a problem at all so far. Everybody, of course, I've been going to him ever since he started, like
right.
pre-kindergarten or preschool. And so everybody's very, very familiar with me and comfortable with me being at the functions. Mm-hmm. And I'm Shelby's mom.
What events, what kind of sports does he enjoy?
Ice hockey.
Really?
Well, since the Predators have come
oh,
to town.
Good grief. My son is wearing me out to do this.
Shelby's been doing it for a year and a half now.
But don't they, like, practice at 5 in the morning?
On Saturday.
Is this a good idea?
No. But low man on the totem pole gets the ice first.
Oh, okay.
So, and we've gotten there at 6 o'clock in the morning with mothers coming out saying, yeah, we were on there first.
Okay.
We were here at 5,
oh.
And we're getting there at 6, so we can't complain.
Okay. No,
it's worth it, though. They love it.
It's such a fun sport.
It is.
But I've never played it. I just love to watch it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I love to watch it.
Ice hockey. Okay.
Yeah.
I hope my son's not watching. I'll have to do it now if he is. Okay. And then we've got a question here. What do you usually buy Narvel and Shelby for their birthdays and Christmas? This is timely because it was
Shelby's
today or
birthday.
Yesterday?
Yesterday was Shelby's birthday.
Right.
And so what I got Shelby were little computer things. To work
computer
on his computer.
Games and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, it's, I go to the computer stores and I say, what's very educational that a 9-year-old will like to play?
Right.
And so that's what I get.
It doesn't involve ripping something's head off.
Yes, exactly. and I get Narvel the WW4 wrestling toys, you know, that you
sure.
hit them and then they speak.
He needs
you,
that.
Yeah, he likes that.
He can vent.
He vents, yeah.
Okay, all right.
Frustrations.
Do you have any household pets? These are all from Diane. She was on a roll. We got
wow.
like a couple of pages
Goodness.
From her. Do you have any household pets? If so, what are they and what are their names?
No.
Interesting name for a pet, but still.
But short and sweet.
Well, how is your new book coming along? This is from Leanne Segriff.
My book is coming along very well. I have turned it in to my editor, Erwin Applebaum, mm-hmm. at Bantam Books, and they are finalizing it now and giving a final proofread, and it should be out in April and available for Mother's Day.
Oh, good. It's called Comfort from a Country Quilt,
yes.
right? Okay, okay.
That was easier for you to say than me.
Comfort from a Country Quilt. Comfort from a Country I rehearsed.
Very good.
I know you just recently toured Europe, sold out. What did you do over there that was most fun for you, not aside from working?
Well, the thing that I enjoyed the most was Berlin. I
oh,
enjoyed
wow.
being in Berlin, going to where the wall was, and going through Checkpoint Charlie. And then we went over into Munich. When we were there, we drove up to the castle that Walt Disney copied to make Cinderella's castle.
Yeah, yeah.
Von Ludwig's
Von something, yeah,
castle.
Yeah.
And it was gorgeous. The countryside was absolutely beautiful.
That's a great part of the world.
I loved all of it. We went to Ireland, Scotland,
did you take
England.
The train down the
no.
Rhine River?
No.
Oh, do that.
We're going back.
It's terribly long, but really gorgeous.
We're going back, so we just kind of hit the high points this time.
Okay.
We had a lot of interviews to do.
Well, as usual, I could talk with you a long, long time, but they're telling me I have to go.
Oh,
thank
really?
You so much.
Bummer. We'll do it again.
Okay.
How about that?
Have fun tonight.
Thanks.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Reba McEntire.